thinking that you might want to be a musician as a profession when you're out, and yeah, that's great. I'm really impressed by what you've got going on here. Amazing that you have a school that's so dedicated to the arts. You guys are lucky, very lucky. I was lucky going by then. I've actually been performing professionally since I was 14. So I got my first break sort of when I was 14. For me, music is like a religion. So spiritually, you know, those goosebumps you get when you listen to music, something really great is happening. That's like a religious experience, and it's incredibly rewarding. Sometimes I wonder, you know, what my life would have been like if I had done something else, gone into, I love science, I love physics, I love psychology, I love a lot of things, advertising. I enjoy writing slogans, I keep track of little slogans I come up with all the time, like I think about it, just, maybe it's from watching Mad Men, but you know, there are a lot of things, you only have one life to live, so you got to find the right path, or find a path. Sometimes I wonder, but it's never been really an option to quit and try something else yet. My violin was made in 1713, so next year is the 300-year birthday. The violin itself is an incredible design. It's evolved, it's like a perfect animal that's evolved for its environment. The violin, the way the shape of the F-holes, the way the bridge is cut out, everything is designed for a specific reason, and they have not improved on it in 300-400 years. So this incredible work of art made by the greatest master that ever lived, it's inspiring, you know. And then I pick out my bow and get to play the music that really was written by the handful of the greatest thinkers that I've ever lived: Beethoven, Bach, you know, Brahms, and others that don't even start with B. These are the greatest minds, you know, so to get exposed to that with this, and I mean, that's so inspiring. So there should be no lack of inspiration, you know, in this business.